They immediately closed the windows. Two guys were holding my hands from the backside and two guys were holding my legs. Another guy was jumping on my body from the seats. Later somebody took me up and he was taking my hands to back, was holding like this. And someone was kicking from the left side at this spot. And two police were holding my head from backside, one police, another guy giving punches from front side. This is the place. I was begging, sir, few days back only I got operated. It's bleeding, sir. Please leave me. Or else, if you feel that I made a mistake, please take me to the police station. Please send me to jail, wherever you want. But don't beat me, sir. I was begging like anything. Yes, at that time, police solidarity have come. With a very mercy face, he asked me that, oh, where you got operated? There is small hope came into my mind. I said that I showed the place. At that time, two people widened my legs and they were kicking. They were kicking on my testicles. Brutal. It was about 6 to 7 minutes. After this, they took my fingers and they kept these fingers on the edges of the steps, and with the strong leathered police boots, they were jumping on my fingers. When I went to hospital, they were trying to put some needle here. I couldn't bear that pain also. Why it happened? Who were beating me at that time? Are Narendra Modi's police or Telangana police? My dear friends, I am not afraid of me. I am not at all afraid of me. But for us, I want to reveal one thing. In front of you, while they were beating me, that police gunda, legal gunda, was talking many things. Let me reveal the things. One is that, how dare you to come to the postmortem? Your friends are there in university. Nobody have come here, but you come here. Yes, my friend Sanjay, Mattakrishna, Suman and me, we four were there, along with Rohit's mother. And also, from us, I went inside to see the postmortem as an eyewitness. He was telling that, why you come to the postmortem? Second thing is that, I was quarreling with the police for one thing, for Rohit's mother's right. She was telling that, long back we came from Guntur and we settled in Hyderabad only. We'll take my body, my son's body to Uppal and we'll bury here itself. But police were forcefully arranged a vehicle and they were trying to shift the body from postmortem place like Usmani Hospital to Guntur. Whom's wish it is? It was the police wish. It was the KCR's wish. It was the upper house wish. It was the Modi's wish. Because there is a angry Usman University. Revolutionary universities are there around Telangana, like around Hyderabad. They'll come, they'll organize some protests. Again, we'll be in defense. So we should take this body to Guntur only. I said one thing, sir, in the morning, you kidnapped the dead body from the University of Hyderabad. Again, you are kidnapping. Who are you to take this dead body? At least in this pathetic condition, hand over the body to her mother, his mother. Let her take the body. But they were not allowing. I quarreled with them. At that time also, this police gunda was holding my hands back and they were was dragging me back. At that time, Cheruk Sudhakar, Mandakrishna Madiga, Thamineni Veerabhadram was there, but they rescued me from that police. Third thing is that Rohit's mother was in that massive, like painful condition. She was telling that, I don't want any politics. Don't drag me into your politics. Please let me go. Let me take my son's body and let me go. She was telling like that. But I said that this is the 8th year. I'm about to finish 8 years in this campus. I said my all past experiences. Pulya Raju was my ordination member. And Bal Raju, he was the senior from the intermediate days. There are many friends whom I have lost in this university because of this brutal administrative politics. I explained each and everything to her and I said that if you won't come to the Hyderabad, again, one more mother will get the same pain as like you. When I was telling these things, again this fellow tried to slap on my chin. And fourth thing is that I'm keep on talking about that this police brutality. Yes, I will. Because yourself, you insisted me to talk about these things. Yourself, you made me to talk about you. I have my research. I have my personal works. Why I'll talk about you? You made me to talk about you. And keep, they are telling that this Lanja Kodku, son of bitch. This Lanja Kodku, son of bitch, keep on talking about the police. How dare you to talk about the police in the public meetings? That is the one of the reasons. And fifth one is that he was telling about Dappu playing and singing songs. Yes. I am a Madiga in this caste society. I used to play Dappu from my childhood days. I used to sing songs from Telangana in 1996 Telangana movement days. And the last thing is that still I am alive. That thing made them to be put some grudge on me. These things I noticed from their words, they were talking many things, but they were closed my they closed my mouth with the police court. I couldn't recognize all the things. I'm remembering these things. At last, I want to tell you, my dear friends, they want to send me to the burial ground. One of my friends there said that, don't hide anything. Speak out whatever you want. That is why I was talking about Police Mukherjee. And also I want to talk about one more fellow. But woman, CIRSI, I don't know her name, and also cadre. They beaten me up and they thrown my body there and they went, they walked just to the steps and they came, that woman police officer came back and she whispered in my ear is that, we are going to kill you. Yes, they have killed already one fellow. Now they want to kill me. My dear friends, I am happy to say this. In few more days, I'll join with you to protect me and you.